Hello and welcome to WaterFire's 2020 Salute to Veterans online video presentation screening. My name is Ed Cabral and I'm the manager of sponsorships and corporate relations at WaterFire Providence. Because of the pandemic, this year WaterFire was not able to have its traditional WaterFire lighting event downtown, but that didn't stop us from continuing this tradition. So we figured out a new way, so welcome. Tonight's presentation is put on in partnership with the State of Rhode Island, the Providence VA Medical Healthcare System, and Prevents, President's Roadmap to Empower Veterans and End a National Tragedy of Suicide. WaterFire Providence will salute our nation's veterans and active duty military personnel and help raise awareness of this ongoing suicide and mental health crisis amongst our veterans and those who have served. Our military, their family, their friends have sacrificed too much to keep our country safe, and we need to do whatever we can to make sure that that sacrifice has not been in vain. We have a lot of special guests this evening, some great musical performances, and our special appearance by our keynote speaker, Dr. Barbara Van Dolan, who's Executive Director of Prevents. I want to take a moment to thank our sponsors who have been so supportive of WaterFire over the years, and especially for our Salute to Veterans event. Citizens Bank, National Grid, Starwood Energy, and Chisholm and Kilpatrick Law Firm. Thank you for your support. I want to make an appeal to you. We're facing unprecedented times and we need your help. I hope that you will consider making a donation to the WaterFire Relief Fund by texting WaterFire to 91999 or go to the WaterFire website, waterfire.org/donate, and help us keep the fires burning. Now, whether you're watching from the WaterFire Facebook Live page, YouTube, or your local Rhode Island PBS station, I want you to sit back and enjoy our show. Thanks for watching.
If you'll join me in prayer, please bow your heads with me. Almighty God, you are the loving creator and gracious sustainer of all. Even as nations rage, rise, and fall, you remain unshakably sovereign. Today we honor our veterans, that small, distinguished group of men and women who have throughout American history, borne the weight of her noble ideals of life, liberty, and freedom. We honor our heroes who have served. We also ask a special blessing of protection over those who continue to serve in harm's way around the globe. Thank you for the service and dedication of our veterans who have defended the line and crushed the advance of tyranny so that our citizens may exercise their unalienable rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. These rights, not given by human function, but are endowed by you, our Creator. As we continue to search for unity in our nation, what a blessing it is that today we can all unite in appreciation and admiration for those who serve and even lay down their own life for the love of country and fellow man. We now ask for your blessing on this ceremony as we celebrate and honor our nation's heroes. Amen.
Oh, say, can you everybody. I'm honored to join WaterFire for this year's Salute to Veterans. I wish we could do this in person, and I look forward to doing that next year. But I'm thankful this event is happening in a way that keeps everyone safe. Here in Rhode Island, we're committed to providing the highest level of support for our veterans, their loved ones, and our Gold Star families. We know there's more we can do for our veterans, especially when it comes to supporting their mental health. But I'm proud of the progress we've made in the past few years to support those who have served, and we're going to keep going. My family knows the importance of service. My grandfather served in World War I. My father and my uncles all served in the Second World War. And they believe strongly in our country and strongly in service. And I know that their courage and dedication exists in every single person who wears our nation's uniform. This year, I'm especially grateful for the service of our National Guard and the leadership of General Callahan. They've been on the ground in every corner of our state, working every day to help us fight the COVID-19 crisis. The men and women of the National Guard have saved lives. I cannot overstate that enough. I am so grateful to them and everything they've done to keep Rhode Islanders safe. So today and every day, I reaffirm my commitment to the veterans who've served us with honor. We owe them a debt that we can never repay. Thank you.
In these difficult and trying times,
while we are isolated from our friends and family,
band members from the United States Army,
Marine Corps,
Navy,
Air Force,
and Coast Guard,
we'd like to salute all the men and women of our armed services.
Whether you have served or are currently serving,
we invite you to stand wherever you are
when your service is presented.
The United States Army.
United States Marine Corps.
United States Navy.
United States Air Force. Thank you.
Coast Guard.
Barnaby Evans, and I'm delighted and honored to welcome you to our 8th annual WaterFire Salute to Veterans. The mission of WaterFire is to honor all those who make our community the special place that it is, and veterans are a critical part of that. The arts and veterans don't necessarily interact much, and WaterFire's mission is to use the arts to celebrate all the strengths of our community. And we feel that including the veterans is a critical part of our mission. I grew up in a family of veterans. My parents and my uncles all served in World War II. And indeed, I was of an age where I just missed Vietnam, but friends and cousins served in that war. And that was a war where we did not properly welcome home the veterans who served. The veterans are upholding the values of our nation and all that we celebrate here at WaterFire. And I cannot think of a more important group to make sure are central to what we are doing. And this year's WaterFire is looking at a particularly important theme. We are looking at the individual veteran and how we can properly recognize their efforts and properly engage them back into the warm embrace of our community. Veteran suicide is a very serious issue and one that we have not paid enough attention to. So with that, I thank you so much for coming and for your years of support for WaterFire, and also for your support for our veteran brothers and sisters. Thank you so much.
I believe the National Guard is the Swiss Army knife of the military. And that is because of the diversity that we bring. Not only diversity in cultural backgrounds, and we get all different skills and elements, you know, from judges, accountants, plumbers, carpenters. That diverse force, that is, it goes beyond just your skill level or your MOS. That is an incredible improvement to the diversity and thought as to how to approach different obstacles and different challenges that we may have.
Good evening, Rhode Island. The 2020 Salute to Veterans WaterFire looks a little different this year. I want to thank our WaterFire team. Your creativity has illustrated the importance of honoring America's heroes. We're also graced this year by having two bands for your listening entertainment tonight. We have the Governor's Own 88th Rhode Island National Guard. We also have Naval Station Newport, the Northeast Band, participating in tonight's festivities. Tonight you heard from our elected officials. That is so critical because our veterans, service members, and military families need to know that that demographic is a priority in our beloved Ocean State. COVID-19 may have changed how we present to you our Salute to Veterans WaterFire, but we are unwavering in our commitment to honoring America's heroes. Speaking of America's heroes, look at the work that our active duty service members have responded during this pandemic. We honor you and continue to thank you for your service. Tonight, we had for the first time our service members enlisted for the first time. To the Defenders of Freedom, our newest members, thank you for your service. The entire state of Rhode Island stands with you and your journey. And you will return home, we will be standing by your side to guide you through your transition. This year, we take time to pause and reflect regarding mental health. We live in a world where we can say it's okay not to be okay. As the stage director, my job is to be there to assist you and to provide assistance where needed. You are not on this island by yourself. But I ask you to take that first step, and we're going to take two steps towards you to get you through this time of need. Likewise, this year we're also honoring our World War II veterans, those that have died this past year. To the surviving family members, this generation of veterans shaped the world. To our Gold Star families, words can't express enough what you mean to us. We are a support system for you because our families are truly the heroes to America's heroes. 2021 is right around the corner. Who knows what next year has in store? But as long as we stand together to honor America's heroes, I know for a fact we're going to get there together. God bless you all. Thank you for joining us tonight. And take care, and we'll see you soon.
Hi, this is Dr. Barbara Van Dalen. I'm so honored and proud to be part of the 2020 WaterFire Salute to Veterans. Thank you for providing me with this opportunity to share a little bit about my connection to veterans and my passion to do all that I can do to ensure that they have the support and resources that they need to continue to lead in our communities. So my connection to veterans really begins decades ago with my father. My father was a first generation American who lied about his age to join the Navy right after Pearl Harbor. He came home, he had seen battle, he had been injured, and looking back, I know that he was dealing with his own invisible injuries of war, though he never talked about that. My dad married my mom, had my three older brothers, and I was born in rural California. My dad taught me about honor, integrity, and most important, service to others. Unfortunately, we had a number of traumas and tragedies during my early years, and it was my dad who was always there, who I could always depend on. My dad encouraged me to pursue my dream to become a clinical psychologist because I wanted to understand mental health issues, mental health challenges, and I wanted to help people heal who were hurting. So I came back east, I went to the University of Maryland where I got my PhD, and I was here on 9/11, right outside of our nation's capital. When 9/11 happened, I knew that those who were going to go to war were going to come home with invisible injuries. It was the memory of my dad. I had lost my dad when I was 27, but the memory and how he inspired me to pursue my dreams and to not let barriers prevent me from doing what I felt needed to be done. I built a national nonprofit organization called Give an Hour that provides free mental health care to those who serve their families and their communities. I was asked to lead Prevents about a year and a half ago. Providence, which was formed as a result of the executive order that the president signed in March of 2019, focuses on several primary areas that the goal is to prevent the national tragedy of suicide. Many of our veterans, as we know, can struggle when they come home for a variety of reasons. And this work is focused on research. It's focused on building community-based efforts and approaches. It's focused on communications. And we've created the first ever national public health campaign called REACH. You can read the roadmap, the Prevents roadmap, by visiting us at va.gov/prevents. You can learn about REACH, the first ever national public health campaign, by going to reach.gov. You can get involved by taking the Prevents pledge to REACH. Please share the pledge. Let your community, let your network know that you are part of the solution. We can all play a role. We all need to play a role. We know that our veterans will help lead the way as we finally tackle the tragedy of suicide. You know, we all have risk factors. We all have protective factors. We can learn, just like we learn about how to take care of ourselves physically, we can learn how to apply those same strategies to take care of ourselves and those we love. But we can't do that if we don't learn risk factors, if we don't learn about protective factors, and if we don't change the culture that surrounds mental health in our nation. I'm proud of the work that we've already done through Prevents. One of the other areas that we focus is on state and local efforts. We've already visited several states. I'm looking forward to coming to Rhode Island to learn more about what Rhode Island is doing to reach your veterans, to engage your service members and their families. Thank you again for this opportunity, for this wonderful opportunity to talk to you about Prevents and about the work we can do together to end suicide. Thank you so much.
Hi, this is Senator Sheldon Whitehouse. There are not many World War II veterans left, which is why I'm so happy that our Veterans Affairs Director, Kasim Yarn, has chosen to focus this WaterFire on our World War II veterans, and through them, our entire veterans community. 92,000 Rhode Islanders served in World War II. One was my father, another was my uncle. My father came home and led a wonderful life serving his country in other areas. My uncle never came home. We really honor what that greatest generation did, and this is a particularly good way to not only honor those values, but to try to summon them back up for our country, which so badly needs them right now. Thank you very much.
Hi, everyone. I'm your Secretary of State, Nellie Gorbea. For this year's salute, I have the honor of recognizing Rhode Island's student veterans. I'm from a three-generation Army family, so I know that transition to student and civilian life isn't easy. That's why the support and community you build in local chapters of the Student Veterans Association are so important for veterans and your loved ones. Our Rhode Island military family must continue to take care of one another. As Secretary of State, I've had the opportunity to team up with the Veterans Business Outreach Center and the Office of Veteran Affairs to support our veteran small business owners. So if running your own business is your next chapter, call me. Thank you to the team at WaterFire, the Office of Veterans Affairs, and Rhode Island's military leaders for organizing this year's salute to veterans and for the work each and every one of you does all the time for our heroes. To all of you, Rhode Island student veterans, whether you're at URI, RIC, CCRI, or one of our private colleges, we see you. We thank you for your service, and we're here for you.
Within the Rhode Island chapters of the Student Veterans of America and the VFW Joint Task Force, there is a vital network of student veterans who are dedicated to preserving our nation's founding principles. They also provide superb resources for developing leadership and academic success. Camaraderie, heritage, professional development, and community outreach are at the core of this committed group of student veterans. Within SVA, there are opportunities for professional growth and lifelong friendships. The solitude we face within this pandemic is a good opportunity to spend time with wellness, physical fitness, and nature. We can focus prayer and meditation on the needs of our neighbors, refine our skills, read inspirational literature, and create quality time with our families. It can be a time of rest and recreation at the church and family level, which is part of the strength of our nation. The flag at our home is not only an ornament or emblem, it is also a banner representing a belief system outlined from the Constitution of the United States. That's what our military and veterans have sworn to protect. It is an honored memorial for fallen heroes, a banner of celebration for those who know the cost of freedom. It holds the ideals which profess that every life matters, not just how we treat each other, but how we hold ourselves to be accountable, upright, civil, and selfless when it comes to the greater good of the world around us. To all of our military personnel and veterans, thank you for your service to our country.
The challenging thing for me would probably be being used to not having my family around.
There's going to be ups and downs with each up and down. You just got to take it as it hits you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Congressman David Cicilline, and I'm delighted to be joining the Rhode Island Office of Veterans Services for their annual Salute to Veterans WaterFire. Today, we come together to commemorate the extraordinary sacrifices of the valiant men and women of the United States Armed Forces. I'd like to begin by thanking the veterans and their families who are watching this today. We owe you an eternal debt of gratitude, and it's our nation's sacred responsibility to ensure that our service members receive the respect and care that they deserve. I join all of my colleagues in government in applauding your courage, your resiliency, and your patriotism. Throughout my time in Congress, I've had the extraordinary privilege of meeting with our men and women in uniform all across the world. Whether it be in Slater Park, Kuwait, or Afghanistan, their unwavering commitment to our country continues to inspire me. At its core, the United States Armed Forces is about service to country, and it is this lifelong legacy of service that makes our military the pride of our nation. In this next segment, we'll see just a few examples of the incredible work being done by our active duty service members every single day. Thank you all for your tireless dedication and service to our community, the state of Rhode Island, and the United States of America.
Since the birth of our nation, men and women have risked their lives in the name of freedom. To all of our veterans, past, current, and future, we want to thank you for what you do for our country and your dedication to duty. From Navy Talent Acquisition Group, New England, happy Veterans Day.
Good evening, and welcome to a very special WaterFire event. While we cannot be together to honor our nation's veterans this Veterans Day, as we normally would, our gratitude for those who have served our nation and the families that have sacrificed alongside them remains unwavering. Americans have proven in every generation that there is no shortage of those with the courage and willingness to serve our nation. These heroes represent the enduring American spirit. We must honor our commitment to provide our veterans and their families with the care that they have earned and remember those who have made the ultimate sacrifice. We owe them much more than we could ever repay. I also ask today that we keep in our thoughts the American servicemen and women who are deployed around the globe and those providing critical assistance here at home. I would also like to recognize and thank the men and women who are beginning their service today as members of the armed forces. Thank you for your willingness to step forward. As a former paratrooper company commander, I know that the greatest privilege an American have is to lead American fighting men and women. It is a profound obligation as well as privilege. You who join today are joining an unbroken line of Rhode Islanders who have served our nation, ensuring our freedoms and the safety of Americans. You represent a new greatest generation, and we are grateful that you keep the spirit of 45 alive. As you embark on this new journey, remember the words of my late friend and colleague, Senator John McCain. Glory belongs to the act of being constant to something greater than yourself, to a cause, to your principles, to the people on whom you rely and who rely upon you. Also remember the words of President John F. Kennedy. Let the public service be a proud and lively career, and let every man and woman who works in any area of our national government, in any branch, at any level, be able to say with pride and with honor in future years, I served the United States government in that hour of our nation's need. Good luck. And my sincere thanks to all those who have served and who've sacrificed. Thank you.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Isabella Vaca.
I, Angel Garcia.
I, Michaela Vento.
I, Moses Cruz.
I, Alejandro Granado.
I, Timothy Bruno.
I, Christian Laredo.
I, Isaac Samoya.
I, Haley Hartung.
I, Larry Golden.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
And the State of Rhode Island.
And the State of Rhode Island.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
And that I will bear true faith.
And that I will bear true faith.
And allegiance to the same.
And allegiance to the same.
And that I will obey.
And that I will obey.
The orders of the President of the United States.
The orders of the President of the United States.
And the Governor of Rhode Island.
And the Governor of Rhode Island.
And the orders of the officers appointed over me.
And the orders of the officers appointed over me.
According to law and regulations.
According to law and regulations.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Isabella Vaca. I enlisted in the Air National Guard in the medical service as a dental assistant. I enlisted in the Air National Guard to carry on a family legacy and attend the University of Rhode Island.
Hi, I'm Alejandra Granados, and I enlisted for security forces, and I decided to join the Air National Guard to learn about the military and for the military experience and to go to school at the same time.
My name is Haley Hartung, and I enlisted in the Air National Guard to continue my film career in public affairs and continue a family legacy and be third generation Air Force.
Hi, my name is Isaac Samoya. I joined the security forces for a better life. I didn't know what to do exactly when I got out of high school, so there was a lot of job offerings in the military, and that's why I joined.
Hi, my name is Moses Cruz. I have enlisted in the Air National Guard with the Cyber Transport Systems position. I have joined for the opportunities, the new people, and the new experiences that the Air National Guard has to offer.
Hi, my name is Lyric Logan. I'm a horizontal construction engineer, and I enlisted in the Army National Guard to set me up financially for college and to provide me life skills in the future.
Hi, my name is Tim Bruno. I'm from Lincoln, Rhode Island. I enlisted in the National Guard as a 31 Bravo, which is a military police officer. And the reason I wanted to enlist is because it allows me to serve my community, and it sets me up for college and for a future career.
Hi, my name is Angel Garcia. I enlisted to the Army National Guard as an 11 Bravo infantryman. I enlisted in the Guard to serve my country, my community, and be the first of my family to serve.
Hi, my name is Christian Laredo. I'm a 42 Alpha, a human resources specialist. I joined for college as well as to help with experience in my future career in law enforcement.
Hi, my name is Michaela Vento. I joined the National Guard as an intelligence analyst to serve my community and learn new skills.
Hi, I'm Congressman Jim Langevin, and I'm so pleased to have an opportunity to send this video message in honor of the 8th Annual Salute to Veterans WaterFire Celebration. I'd like to begin by thanking Barnaby Evans, the founder of WaterFire, for organizing this event again this year, especially during such challenging times. Additionally, I'd like to thank the rest of the WaterFire staff and volunteers who have adapted and overcame these difficult circumstances to honor our veterans. Despite these unprecedented times, it's so important that we continue to take the time to reflect and pay tribute to the veterans who have bravely served our nation. To all of our veterans, thank you for your service. I especially want to recognize and honor the Gold Star families, the loved ones who made the ultimate sacrifice and service to our nation. We know that there are no words to adequately thank them or you for what they did on behalf of all of us. We will never forget their sacrifice, and they and you continue to be in our thoughts and prayers. To all of those who continue to serve in uniform and defend our nation, thank you for your selflessness and devotion to our country. Whether you are supporting ongoing efforts against COVID-19 here in our great state of Rhode Island, supporting pandemic relief elsewhere in the country, or serving overseas, we owe you an immeasurable debt. This is a debt that we can only begin to repay by keeping our promises and providing the services and supports that you have rightfully earned in service to our country. As a member of Congress, I will continue the fight in Washington to ensure that we make good on that commitment. With that, I'd like to introduce the torchbearers for tonight's ceremony. And once again, to all of our veterans, I sincerely thank you for your service. May God continue to bless each and every one of you, and may God continue to bless the United States of America.
WaterFire Salute to Veterans. Every year and every day, we come together to honor those men and women who have answered the call to defend our nation. These are ordinary men and women who do extraordinary things, and it is due to their sacrifice that we as Americans enjoy the freedom and the prosperity that we've all come to treasure so much. I want to thank everyone at WaterFire for organizing the Salute to Veterans for 8 years now, including this year virtually. And I want to thank all of the men and women who have served our country in uniform and their families who have sacrificed as well to benefit our country and all Americans. Thank you for your service. Thank you for all that you do. And it is an honor for us to come together as a state to show our appreciation once again this year.
This year, we lost a revered member of our team, Sergeant Major retired Gary Fortunato. Sergeant Major Fortunato was an integral member of the Army community and a hallmark of the Providence College ROTC Patriot Battalion family. Sergeant Major Fortunato dedicated his life to military service, serving in the U.S. Army for 53 years, including a 30-year active duty career with service in Vietnam, in Operations Desert Storm and Desert Shield in Saudi Arabia and Iraq, and 23 years with the Providence College Army ROTC program. During his 30-year military career, he served in numerous leadership positions to include Senior Drill Sergeant, two First Sergeant positions in Vietnam, and served as Sergeant Major for NATO Land Forces and U.S. Army Europe and Germany. He earned more than a dozen awards and citations, including the Legion of Merit, the Bronze Star Medal with Valor Vice, Meritorious Service Medal, the Army Commendations Medal, and the Rhode Island Star. But of all of his accomplishments, he was most proud of his time as a teacher and mentor to the future leaders of the U.S. Army. Sergeant Major Fortunato was a leadership instructor and operations officer for the Patriot Battalion for 23 years. Nowhere was Sergeant Major Fortunato's focus more engaged than on his cadets and their development in character, skills, and leadership. He was an integral part of the development of over 350 commissioned officers into the United States Army. His gift to each cadet was revealing their potential as military leaders and harnessing the ability to push past their expectations. As we reflect on Sergeant Major Fortunato's life, let us be reminded of the impact that one person can make on their organization and the people that comprise it. Sergeant Major Fortunato was the consummate leader, mentor, and friend to all those who had the privilege to serve with him. His devotion to duty and sense of selfless service quintessentially define the American soldier. A great nation is one that honors and remembers its fallen heroes. They made the ultimate sacrifice so those that remained could continue to prosper, live in freedom, and enjoy a way of life which is envied throughout the world. We cannot speak to the sacrifice of our military without mentioning those who sacrificed silently along with them, their families. Our service members are predominantly successful because of the support they receive at home. It is of great importance that we recognize Rhode Island's 33 Gold Star families. The phrase Gold Star family dates back to World War I, when military families displayed service flags featuring a blue star for every immediate family member serving in the armed forces. The star's color would be changed to gold if the family lost a loved one in the war, hence the term Gold Star family. The strength of our Army is our soldiers. The strength of our soldiers is our families. The Army recognizes that no one has given more for the nation than the families of the fallen. My words today could never express our undying gratitude for our service members who made the ultimate sacrifice and their loved ones who have had to endure without them. As the months and years have passed, our indebtedness to you all for your sacrifice remains. The sorrow and heartache of their loss will never be completely erased, and we will always honor their service, a service that perpetually inspires our great nation. Our Gold Star family service members represent the best this nation has to offer, the American warrior. Selfless, courageous, devoted, and true, these are the qualities embodied by these men and women, which bind our nation. We honor their service today. We remember their selflessness and sacrifice forever. God bless all our servicemen and women, but especially today, God bless our veterans and our fallen and our Gold Star families.
Lieutenant Governor Dan McKee, and I'm so honored to be part of this year's Salute to Veterans WaterFire. This is a ceremony that I've enjoyed participating in many times, and even though this year's celebration looks a little different, it feels good to be able to continue the tradition of honoring those who have served and their families. So let me start by saying thank you. Thank you to all who have served. Thank you to everyone who has worked hard to bring us together virtually this year. Thank you to our veterans for their bravery, fortitude, and selfless service. We owe them our eternal gratitude. Thank you to our National Guard, members who have stepped up in remarkable ways to aid Rhode Island's COVID-19 response. We are so grateful now and always to have one of the very best National Guards in the nation. Thank you to every single Rhode Island active duty and reserve member. We salute you. And thank you to our Blue Star and Gold Star families for the sacrifices they continue to make every day. Our hearts are with you. I would also like to take a moment to share that in the spirit of supporting our service members and their families, just last month, my office relaunched the Rhode Island Military Family Relief Fund. This fund provides emergency grants to our military families in need, and we could use your support to continue this important work. If you can, take a minute to learn more by visiting the Lieutenant Governor's Office website. I'll wrap up with this final reminder that we can't repeat enough. When it comes to supporting those who have served, and showing our gratitude for their service, every day is Veterans Day. Thank you, God bless you all, and God bless the United States of America.
Will you join me in prayer once more? Thank you, God, for this time that we've had to focus on the tremendous service and sacrifice of our nation's military veterans. And as we conclude, may we all be inspired toward service by their example, compelled toward sacrifice, and reignited in our passion for our nation. As we seek unity in our land, we need not look any further than our veterans, who have put aside all minor differences for the good of the cause and the execution of the mission. God, I pray that you would strengthen all of us for the difficult task of humility, not considering our own life as more important than that of our neighbor. As we desire to once again be the shining city on a hill, the example to the world of opportunity and freedom, may we become increasingly aware that it is you who gives light, and where there is light, darkness cannot exist. We ask for your light to shine on our nation and heal our land. For our veterans who willingly defend her, with her warts and failings, may you bless them now and always. We ask this in all things by the power of your holy name. Amen.